you've had a few hits in your life.
Yep.
You get shot in the head.
Yep.
At a UB40 yep. concert.
Yep.
How was that feeling?
I was in a time of peace too. And I had been just released on parole, my first parole. And my wife then got me these tickets to go and see UB40 because I loved UB40. Mm-hmm. And because of the conflict, bands like UB40 wouldn't come to Belfast. We didn't get the likes of that because it was a dangerous place to come. But now I'm peace. So she's, oh, me, oh, brilliant. They were playing in Belfast. Happy days. So get the tickets, we're going that night. And because there was peace, I thought, well, there's peace, that means there's no more war. But my men around me were saying, you can't go up there, John. I hear me, but sure, there's peace. We'll be all right. It's a lovely summer's night. Open our concert. Me and the wife will go, oh, no, Johnny, you need the minders. I mean, I don't need minders. So he goes up, and it was a great night. And the next thing, bang, I got shot point blank range in the back of the head. Not only did I get shot, one of the fought with me after it, but the grace of God, I lived, I survived it. Obviously, it must have been a damp round. I seen the round, it was crazy, and it was a big lead slug. But obviously, it must have been a damp round when there must have not been enough gunpowder in it. Because had it been a newish round, it would have just blew my brains completely off. I wouldn't have. But it just went into my head and travelled and lodged there. So, and I was only out on parole, and we phoned the jail, told them I couldn't go back. They couldn't believe that he'd be shot in the head. And Johnny, you're at your work now. Come on now. I've been shot in the head. If they go to the hospital and we're going to take the bullet out. But people couldn't believe how could you get shot in the head and walk away from it. But I did.
So the person that shot you in the head, you were still fighting with them?
No, they fought with me. See, when they shot me in the head, when I went down, I thought it was a grenade with a big flash. And then I just, the way you see in a film, you know, like you're shot, you stagger about and all. And I knew. I mean, well, I'm not dead, but everything was going through my head. And I could just see my wife in slow motion. And the next thing, I remember fighting with them, right? And they tried to get me down. And I remember, the grace of God, I got away anyway. And ironically, when I got the car that got me to my safety, it turns out that because I knew through police, taking statements, all these taxis, whatever, but he was a Catholic. And when I got into the car, you know who I am? And he's, the man was panicking. I said, hospital. And then I realized, no, don't go to the hospital because if they think you're alive, they realize you're alive, they could come back to the hospital and finish you off. So I told him to go to Shangle and he was panicking, but he took me to Shangle. Oh,
he must have been shitting himself.
And I never realized he was a Catholic until after the police had told me, he said, Johnny, you'll never believe this, but see that guy saved your life, the guy in the white car. He said he was a Catholic. I mean, oh, fuck.
Does that not make you realize, though, Johnny, and go, just, you know what? It's all kind of madness and
but the story goes, you see that this is what I hear, because I mean, you hear stories and then when they returned me to prison, put me in a segregated jail, you know, Catholics and Protestants, and that was the first time that I was in amongst Catholics. It was hard because I was the devil to them, but some of them became good friends of mine and they told me things, you know what I mean, which was important. And one of the stories they told me was this guy had shot me. Now, he wasn't a Republican, he was an opportunist, right? And it turns out he was heavy on the coke. They spotted me there, Johnny, at their mom will shoot him. So obviously they got the gun, they done what they had to do. But this guy threw the paper down to me one day, the Andersonstown News. It was a Catholic guy in the jail. He says, "Who's your mate?" And I looks at it, it was a death thing. The guy had been dead a year. I said, I didn't know who shot me. I hadn't a clue who it was. The police didn't know at that time because they thought it was mainstream Republicans.
Did they have a mask on?
So no, bare-faced. So the guy threw the thing down, but this guy had been dead a year. But it turns out it was the actual guy that shot me, but he was flat out in a coke and he got paranoid and he moved to Dublin. He thought that we were coming after him and we were closing in on him. He hung himself, left a suicide note. Johnny Adurna's man's closing in on me. I can't live with this anymore. And he fucking hung himself. I didn't even know who he was. And he thought that I knew who he was and we were coming close. Flat out in coke, hung himself.
Did you think that was a, sorry, just a wee thing to right. on it. No, did you put them on your sleeves at the table? Did you think that was a hit then, a professional hit, and you just kind of...
At the time, yes, everybody did, yep, the police and all was...
Because no mask, no nothing.
And even at the time, the people associated, the loyalists, who'd be loyal to me, they were actually going out and retaliating within hours and days after. I think there was...
So Catholics were getting killed just because...
There was shootings and fought. Yes, because they thought that was Republicans. And I think messages was sent through our political parties that it was nothing to do with the IRA or mainstream Republicans.
That's nuts.
That is.
Do you remember what UB 40 song it was?
Oh, it was a horrible song too. It was a fucking song. One of the very few UB 40 songs, I hate it. And it was the first time I heard it. It was about a train. And I remember, I remember even saying, I don't like that song.
You don't fucking like it anymore.
And that song's fucking stuck with me.
Because I think
the train is coming or something. Fuck that.
Your train was nearly there, Johnny. I think you've had a lot of hits in your life as well, but a lot of these people aren't breathing anymore either.
I know. Well, that's the way it goes.
Is that retaliation? Is that
no? It's not. I don't know. Some of the people I knew that tried to kill me have been sent to prison. Some of the people in the process of trying to kill me actually killed themselves with bombs, and others. I think I don't know. People's just took the law into their own hands, sort of speaking.
I can't believe the guy who shot you. I thought it was a hit. And I never.
No. It was just an opportunity. We're Catholics, like, and here was Johnny Adair stuck with no menders, just with his wife. And an open-air concert, more or less in their turf. And there was a big crowd of them. And ironically, another one, the main instigator who was fighting that night, who was an amateur heavyweight boxer, he was one of the aggressors, right? But ironically, he was shot dead.